Hi, today we are going to see about binary search algorithm. You know what is searching? Searching means you are going to find some value or some element from the list. This is called searching. Today we are going to see about the binary searching. This binary searching is only possible when there is a sorted list in the ascending order. So you cannot use this binary searching technique for the list which is having the element in the random order. This is only possible with the sorted list. As per the searching technique, you can search any of the element from the list. If the element is found, then you will be getting the message like element is found. If it is not found, then you will be getting like there is no element in the list. But this is something different in binary search algorithm. Like, it is not like a normal linear search. First, I will tell the procedure how this binary search algorithm works. First, it will find the first it will start to search from the element with the middle of the list. First it will take the number and it will find the middle element from the list. First it will compare that with the middle term. If the middle term and the search element is getting matched, then it will tell the element is found. Otherwise, this will be checking whether this search element is smaller or larger than the middle element. If the search element is smaller than the middle element, then it will repeat the same step to the left sublist of the middle element. If the searching element is greater than the middle element, then this will do the same process to the right sublist of the middle element. This process will be repeating till it is finding the search element from the list. And if you don't have the element in the list, then it will be telling element is not found in the list. So we can see the example so that you will be understanding the procedure completely about the binary search technique. Just consider this list, which is having 9 elements. Now we are going to search the element number 12 from the list. First step is it will just check the 12 element with the middle element of the list. In program we can write some mathematical formula to find the midterm. Okay, so I will tell you in program. Now just see, this is the middle element. Manually you can see this. This having 9 elements, so 4 is the middle element. First it is checking with this middle element. This is 12, obviously both are not equal. So what it will do, second step, it will check whether this 12 is lesser than 50 or greater than 50. This 12 is lesser than 50. So this again it will check the same process with the left sublist. So 10, 12, 20 and 32, it will do the same process in the left sublist, which means it is going to search the 12 in the left side sublist. Now 12 will be again searched, again it will find the middle element from this sublist. Now your new last element will be 32. This thing you have to update in the program. Now again this will find the midterm middle element. So here it is 4. So if you will write some formula, then it will find 1 is the midterm. It will check that 12 is equal to 12. So it is same. It will be matched, then you will be getting the messages element is found. So over of searching. I will tell you another example. number 80, same process. 80 will be first compared with number 50 middle term of the original list. This both are not equal. This 80 is greater than 50. So it will do the searching process in the right sublist of the original list. So it will remove all this, then it will be doing the searching in the right sublist. And the new element, or the first element, is 5, because it is going to search from the right side. Last element will be same. Next, it will find the 80 from the right sublist. Again, it will compare the 80 with the middle element. We will be writing one formula in a program. According to that formula, you will be getting middle term as 6. It will check 65 is equal to 80. It is not equal. Again, 80 is greater than 65. So, it will check in the right sublist of this one. So, it will remove 55. Again, it will check in 80 and 99. Again, it will find the midterm. Now, it will check with that midterm. Now, 80 is the midterm and 80 is equal to 80. So, now you will be getting the output as element is found at the index 7. Here some mistake, both are same, both are matching. It's not matching, some mistake is there. So, same like this I have written the program. I have declared an header file. Then this is a main program. Inside this I have just declared the variable integers, first, last, middle. These three terms will be used to recreate, like every time the first and middle term and the last, sorry, first, last and middle index of that list is getting changed in the binary search algorithm. So, I need first, last and middle terms and size of the list. Then I is for the for loop, S element is to find the search element, this is to create the list. Now, I am getting the size of the list from the user. I am just scanning it in ampersand size. Then I am getting the inputs from the user to create the list. Here you have to enter it in the ascending order. Then I am getting I no need to give n times, like 10. If you are going to create the list with the 10 numbers, then 10 times you no need to give the printf. For that I am using for loop. I am using for loop and I am just getting the inputs from the user to create the list. Next, I am getting the search element from the user. Now I am first declaring first element is 0, then last element is size minus 1. Middle element, to find the middle element, I have written the formula first plus last divided by 2. Okay. For the left side, first will be always 0, but if you will go for the right sublist, first will be getting changed. So I am writing first plus last divided by 2. So inside while loop, I am giving condition. First element is less than or equal to last. If this condition is true, then it is going here. First it is check in if condition. I am giving list of middle is less than S element. If it is list of middle is less than S element, then I am writing first is equal to middle plus 1. This condition is for number 80. Okay. See, here the search element is given as 80. List of middle means this is 4. According to our condition, list of middle is lesser than S element. If this is lesser than S element, lesser means 80. Okay, if it is lesser than S element, then your new list will be this one. So that time first element will be 5. So you have to give this 5 as the first element and last element will be 8. So I am writing first is equal to middle plus 1. So now middle is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5. So it has to start from the 5. That's why I have given first is equal to middle plus 1. Else if list of middle equal to equal to S element, in case this 80 is equal to 50 is equal to 80 means here you have to show the output element is found at the index percentage D comma middle. Okay, if it is both are matching at the first search only, I am telling. If it is not, then first element will be 1. Again it will go here, again this thing will be repeating. Else what I have to do, in case this list of middle is not lesser than S element. Okay, not less than means this is greater than S element means you have to give, this is for the first condition. Okay, because 12 is lesser than 50. In this case first element is 0, the last element is 3. So in that case you should change the last element as middle minus 1. So I am giving last is equal to middle minus 1. Again I am giving the same formula, middle equal to first plus last divided by 2. This is for another condition. One more condition is first element is greater than last element, then which means it is not it doesn't find the value from the list. That time I am giving element does not found in the list. In case this 80 is not found, then I am giving element is not found in the list. Just I am running and showing the output. First I am compiling it, then I am running it. This is asking the size of the list. I am giving 5. I have to give the integer values in ascending order only. Now it is asking to search. I am giving 34 and it is finding the index is 1. So this program is working under this binary search algorithm. So hope you understand the concept. I will meet you in next video. Thank you.